bring to focus all the similar cases, you cannot really answer this question. Now, I know positively that these things happen not only in the Christian world, but also in the world of Buddhists, in the who do not believe in God, in the world of Confucian, followers of Confucius, and in the world of the followers of Zoroaster, and then in the world of Islam and elsewhere. So what would be the result? What would be the inference? If that shows the religion they adhere to is correct in theology, then all these religions would be correct in theology. And if that is correct, then this exclusion is definitely incorrect. Because they cannot at the one and the same time be correct. They are opposing, they are paradoxical to each other. So what should be the right conclusion, logical conclusion? The logical conclusion is divided in two parts. In the Holy Quran, the philosophy is mentioned of this, of similar situations. The Holy Quran categorically tells us that being Rahman, being extremely merciful, his mercy covers not only the believers, but also the non-believers. Also sometimes those who are opposed to him. Also sometimes to the idolaters who do not turn to God but to the falsely created gods. Knowing all this, when at the time of crisis they pray to God in urgency, he listens to them and forgives them. And also helps them get out of that predicament, knowing that once they have got out, they will again start calling partners with Allah and attribute their deliverance to the false gods, not to him. Yet Allah does it. What a beautiful conclusion. No contradiction left in the world. That means that if such a situation happens, the only inference you can draw is that God is extremely merciful. That is all. It will not give any certificate to the adherents of such a religion. That can only happen if there is a challenge, positive, clear challenge, thrown by one religion to the other, and where on the authority of God, a claimant says that now my prayers are heard and your prayers are not going to be heard because I truly belong to Allah and you do not belong to that God who is the real God and the creator of the universe. Now if you doubt my claim, come and let's go into contest, and you'll see the result. If that happens, even then, there are difficulties involved. I mean, no definite conclusions can be drawn from some point of view, but from other points of view, some definite conclusions can also be drawn. Now, what would happen in such a situation? There is a possibility that both of them are false. Neither he belongs to God nor the other person belongs to God. And they are just taking chances, and one of them ultimately comes out victorious. That is possible. It is also possible that one person truly belongs to God. And his claim is based on truth, and ultimately the resultant shows that he is right. Now, how will you be able to judge whether this thing happened through accident or through design, through decree of God? Only a situation can tell you. And there are situations described by Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, the founder of the Ahmadi community, which leave no ambiguity. For instance, there are two instances where he threw such a challenge to his adversaries, and you analyze the situation logically, and the only conclusion you can draw is that if Masih Maud al-Salam ultimately became victorious, it was only through design of God and not through just by a chance declaration, nothing more. What happened in the one instance was that he addressed his Christian opponents and he said, look here, you believe that Messiah had a very special power of curing people. We also believe, but in a different way, of course, spiritual power we mean. But you believe that he could physically cure such cases who were lost to medical science. Yet I take you on your claim. Though I do not ascribe the same meanings to this claim, I take it spiritually. Yet if you want to prove that God is with me, I have been permitted by God to throw this challenge to you. Choose some patients and choose those patients in a manner of a similar disease that the worse are given to me, and those who are comparatively in a better condition, they belong to you. No medicine, no treatment is being given to either of the two, 50 each side. And you also pray to your Jesus Christ, and I'll pray to my God and the only God. And the test would be that if predominantly my patients are allowed, the patients allotted to me, who were declared by the medical specialists to be the worst cases, they survive out of all proportion, in excess to the patients who survive in your case, then obviously there is something. It's not just a chance. But this is a very logical approach, and the same approach was made by Sheikh Mubarak Ahmed Sahib, one of our ex-missionaries, the missionary in charge of America nowadays, who has been here in London as well, but at that time he was in Kenya. Or was it Tanzania? I think Kenya. Kenya. Bailey Graham went there and he posed him. He threw this challenge to him and said, look here, I am the follower of a holy man who in his lifetime did this to his adversaries from the Christians. So although I am not a holy man according to my own claim, but I do hope that because I belong to the righteous, to the right path, and I am a true sincere servant of that holy person, so Allah will show his blessing to me and will also show the same miracle at my hands through our prayers. So I extend the same challenge to you, and I hope you will accept it. Most of the hospitals are Christian missionary Christian hospitals, and they would decide the issue. Divide the patients between us and we'll see what the outcome. And Billy Graham ran away. He fled from this challenge. Now, this should not be extended too far. This I must tell you. Because if you start taking these things lightly, without an authority, then perhaps you will find it yourself in a very difficult position. Sometimes Allah may punish you by saying that, look here, what nonsense. These things should not be extended too far. But there are occasions, like the occasion in the lifetime of Hazrat Masih Maud al-Salam, when a very positive challenge is thrown to the rest of the world, and a long time duration is given to them for accepting that challenge. And when they do, then God shows such miracles. For instance, this is what happened in the case of Doi. He was addressed by Masih Maud al-Salam, and he behaved most arrogantly and most proudly, and condemned Islam and the Prophet of Islam,